Okay, so we want to thank the panelists. We also want to thank Sheer Excellence for allowing us to bring Shop Talk here. So first we have Chris King, we have Larry D, we have Eli White, we have DJ Mitchell, we have Mr. Darren Watson, we have Donald Mitchell, and we have Drew Shaw. Thank you so much. And we also have Keeping It Real with Michelle, which is the co-host that's going to be helping facilitate and express these questions to you guys. Okay, so the first question that we wanted to ask the panel of young men is, do you guys feel that vision is important in relationships and marriage? And how important do you feel that vision is?
Because without vision, you perish. And so what happened is that you have to have a vision, and two people have a vision, and then you try and become as one. And the vision sometimes be different because somebody, when you're supporting the husband, the wife supporting the husband, she thinks she's losing her vision. So she has her own vision, but then you have to have communication. And conflict might come in because you're going two separate ways at one time, and you're trying to figure out who's supposed to be helping each other. When men need encouragement in their vision, we would bring home the bacon, we would do everything we can, but we need encouragement.
Yes.
We need to be pushed, we need to be loved, and don't take this the wrong way. In all areas of life, make that man feel like he a man.
Come on.
Huh? Hey. He gonna get to a certain age where sometimes he can't do some things, and then the woman feel like a certain way. But at the same time,
yes,
you got to encourage that man so he can go forward and the family can grow and go forward. But vision is very important. We have to have a vision, because if not, we perish. You know, and the vision is to grow, to learn, to help, to encourage. We all need encouragement. We all need to be helped and pushed along. Without a push, without encouragement, the man feel like he on an island by himself.
I want to say that vision is very important. Anything that's done that's good, it has to be intentional. When you think about a building, you know, you got to have a vision of what that building is going to look like, how you're going to do it. If not, it's going to be a lot of inefficiency. I believe it's a lot of inefficiency within relationships because there is no vision. You're just willy-nilly just going with the vibe. You know what I mean? And I feel like as far as relationship and building things like that, it's very important to be on the same page with the same mindset, with the same process to get to the same end goal. Boom.
Yes, come on.
I want to piggyback off what the two gentlemen said in regards to vision. My perspective, based upon the question that was asked, I think that vision is very important as a man in general, especially going into a relationship. If a man doesn't have a vision per se for himself, he can't be effective in a relationship trying to bring along a spouse or somebody like that. So because he won't have a clear-cut direction of where he's trying to go. So I think that's why vision is very, very important. I think it's one of the most important things in a relationship. You know what I mean? So like you said, without a vision, the people perish. So yes, I think that vision is very important. I think that it may be one of the most important factors in a relationship outside of God. You know what I mean? But vision ties to purpose. So I believe that vision is very important.
I want to hear the rest of the young men, but also I want to kind of throw out for them to be thinking about some ways that they can give some tips, some tools that women can learn how to be what the man needs.
Right.
Because, you know, with communication is key. However, if we don't know really what to communicate to you about, as far as what that looks like for you, then I think that it kind of has a woman crippled from really like being what she needs to be for you.
Mm-hmm.
So be thinking about maybe some things that you can throw out there and say, hey ladies, this is one of the ways that we would want you to communicate, or these are the things that you guys can do to kind of draw that out of you guys. I think that'd be important too.
Mm-hmm.
But be mindful of the second question as well, because like you were saying with the encouragement piece, hold on to that, because the next question is going to ask, you know, what do you feel or what do you need from a woman? So keep that in mind. Okay, we want to make sure that we expose both questions so that way you all have enough time to answer the question accordingly. Okay, sounds good.
Sounds great.
Vision is a double-edged sword. It's a thin line. I've been married to the same woman for 35 years, and I've learned that through my vision or her vision, it's not necessary both of our visions. So you have to be able to adjust that, and I can give a perfect example of that for me is that when my wife wanted to cook, so we opened up a restaurant here locally, and after so many years of it, she got tired of doing it, but I wanted to continue to do it, which I continue to do now. But the thing she said to me was, Drew, your vision isn't my vision, and it hurt it, but I had to understand where she was coming from. When she said that, I understood. I stopped back and I was like, wow, you would think you would be with somebody this long and you would think y'all on one or everything is everything, but it's not. It's, you know, you have to live your separate ways of certain things. I have to live mine certain ways, but when it comes to certain things, we talk about it. When you talk about it, that makes all the difference in what you're doing. So vision is a double-edged sword. So if you learn to learn from it and learn to listen is the most important thing, then a lot of it will come more simply for you.
I think that especially for a man, that vision is imperative. Also because just as a man as himself by himself, a man needs a vision because it allows him to be able to pick a spouse. Not negating what these gentlemen said and different things like that. But when it comes to relationships, God has given each and every last one of us an individual purpose. Mm-hmm. So if I know that this is what God has purposed me to do, this is the direction that he wants me to go in and he wants me to flow in, by me having this vision, this woman over here, she could be perfect. She could be everything naturally, but she may not line up with what God's vision for me is.
Come on.
You know what I mean?
That's
in general.
Good.
So yeah, I think that vision is very important in helping choose the right spouse for your relationship and different things like that, so then it can flow a little bit better. That's I think that's a principle thing. That's not nothing that we have to pray about. That's not nothing that we have to seek a whole lot of counsel on. I mean, if I'm going in this direction right here, it shouldn't be nothing that detours me to go to other, because I know where I'm going. So that's why vision is important.
Yeah.
You know.
So say that, you guys. So say that, you know, what I mean, you get into a relationship and you don't know your vision.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Because a lot of people go into relationships not organic like that, where it's like, okay, I know my vision, I know what I want to do. You know what I mean? And they may have been in a relationship in their 20s or so, and they don't know. You know what I mean? And so going through the relationship, you know, where you don't know it, now it's figuring out, you know, like, all right, you know, you're going through real life situations, you know, with family, you may have kids or so, and you know, now it's like, all right, Lord, what do I do now? You know what I mean? Like, I feel like I'm figuring out myself, I'm learning myself, you know, what do I do? You know what I mean? And that's that point now where, you know what I mean, it's diving deep, you know what I mean, and even getting real, even in a real relationship with God, you know, where it's like, look, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to lead my family. You know what I mean? I don't know what to do, Lord. What is my vision? You know what I mean? I want to do this. This is not. I'm good at this. I'm good at that. I have these business ventures doing this and that, but I'm still lacking in this area. So what do you guys think as far as that?
When we talking about vision right now, I feel we talking vision in the marriage area, right? But we got to remember, to me, vision ain't coming until you start the date process. So I feel once you even start that relationship, right, you should be already on one accord on what you want to do with yourself. So God gonna bring your mate to you, like he said.
Come on.
He gonna bring what you desire. So what you living, what you thinking, how God, when you pray to God and you move with God, he gonna bring what you want to you, right? So when you don't know when he bring it to you, sometimes you don't know, because it be too early, because we still young.
Right.
But we got that faith that because we men of God. Yep. That's how we walk. So when some come to us, right, we take it and we take it in stride. But we got that strength of God, so we think we be lost sometimes when stuff be happening, but we don't. Right. We just moving with God. Because he said the enemy going to throw stuff at you all the time. What you got to do? You got to shrug it off. Shrug it off. But keep your vision. Because your partner going to catch on to your vision. Because you moving with God. Yeah. And they going to come with you. That's how I see it. It start off when you dating. Not when you get married.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It continues when you get married. But I feel if, when you dating somebody, y'all already know what y'all doing. Because the end goal is marriage. The vision is marriage. Because that's the covenant that God, you know what I'm saying? You should know.
So now can you say that before you get to that part, do you have to date yourself? Do you have to date yourself first? Do you have to date yourself? Do you actually have to, you know what I mean? All right, look, I'm not going to get in a relationship for a year or so. You know what I mean? I'm going to figure out things. You know what I mean? I know which way I want to go. Mm-hmm. I know what type of woman I want. You know what I mean? I know my direction, you know, that I want to go to. But maybe I have to just sit back for a second. You know what I mean? It's like, look, Lord, you know what I mean? I'm going to be abstinence from, you know, I'm not going to have sex. Amen. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to dig into certain things that I normally, my flesh wants to do. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to actually mold with God, you know what I mean? And actually did, you know what I mean? And actually really know my purpose for, like, before getting into
right.
that.
Come on.
Definitely live and learn. And talking about vision and then the relationship, because we in the relationship, when we live and learn and then we seek God, as my man was saying, we spend that quality time that God is going to direct our path and the woman's going to catch on. Because
yeah.
What happened is if you allow the Holy Spirit
to
take control, because I had to learn, I'm learning now, that the Holy Spirit has to be in control and not my way or not my will. So I ain't huffing and puffing like my mama would do to me or, you know, how I was raised. I'm calm with it now and not blaming nobody, not my father because he wasn't in my life or nobody else. Just know that, okay, I got to make a change. And my wife said she was sick and tired of our situation. I said, well, she tired. I'm sick and tired. So I'm going to do something about it. So I'm going to seek him.
Yeah.
I'm seeking him for direction.
Yes.
Huh? For the vision to make it plain. They say write it down. Habakkuk 2 and 2 say write it down and make it plain. Make the vision plain. I just ate on this morning. So it was just the Holy Spirit when the call came to me to ask me. Because I was feasting on it this morning. About how to just make it plain. We got to write it down. I heard Steve Harvey say, write it down. He said, Oprah Winfrey, for 30 years, told you make a vision board.
Yeah.
Make it plain. So it's going to line up because I'm going to work hard because I'm determined.
Yeah.
I just read a book about my man. He's talking about a shift. It's shift goes on in our life.
Yeah.
The Pastor Kendrick talks about shifts. It's shifts in our lives that goes on in our life that we got to catch up with. The shift, when the shift goes on, you just got to roll with it. Like my man say, you're going to roll with that shift. You're going to roll with life. You're going to make your mind saying and say, I'm determined.
Yeah.
I'm determined to be successful.
Yeah.
I'm determined to have something. We was talking about that in the barbershop the other day about what the mindset.
Mm-hmm.
The old gentleman said something important. You got to love yourself first.
Okay, go ahead.
I want to add to that. Sometimes we want a woman, huh? But God might give you a woman that you need.
Whoa, come on.
You might want to have Coca-Cola shape model. I want her with long hair, 6 foot, Amazon. You might put a list down of what woman you want. And then God might say, no. I'm going to give you this because this is the woman you need.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Like my wife, she stay on my head because she want me to do what my inner self, she know my inner self can do.
All right.
She know who I am inside. So she don't let me slack off.
Amen.
And sometimes we balance each other.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all the time we balance each other because she's business.
Yeah.
I'm real like supernatural. So we balance each other out. When she, you know, have a hard time, when I have a hard time. So that's really what it's about with vision, because her vision might be, you know, she got, like he was saying, she got her own vision. I got my vision, what I'm going to do, but we come together and we put each other's, you know, strengths together and we do it.
Just like the scripture says, you perish without a vision. I believe that if you don't know your vision, you will not know where you're going, nor will you know when you get there. But just as important as having a vision, I think that for men, we need to understand how to communicate, effectively communicate that vision to the woman, because if you can't communicate that vision to the woman, then she won't know precisely what her job is and what she needs to do in that relationship. So vision is very, very important.
So here we go, tips, here we go. This is something, I think this is, I'm about practical exercises. Okay. So this is a good way that we can have a vision collectively, an exercise that couples can do. Statistically, they say that a lot of relationships fail because of money. Really, it's the lack of management of money. So good exercise, let's say man and woman get together, we got $250,000. What is your vision for how we should manage this $250,000 going forward? A lot of things: housing, transportation, health insurance, business investment, savings, emergency savings, you know what I'm saying, things like that. And then when you can see your spouse's vision, you come up with your vision, then you guys can align what your priorities are. I believe that you can have better results, more intentional results, and not just kind of be together in a relationship going forward with no specific plan financially and no mental reps to prepare you when you do get the money. I think that's another thing too. We have to have the vision on before we can actually get to that situation where we got $250,000 and got to make life decisions. Let's visualize, have a vision, what we're going to do before that opportunity comes. So when we get that opportunity, now we can execute.
So go back to Mr. Donald when he said that men have to find effective ways of communicating what God has laid on their heart. Because it's very important. We are not mind readers, and I know y'all throw that out there like y'all are not mind readers. We aren't either. So with that being said, if there is something that is on your heart, because like the young man was saying, seasons and moving with the flow and the wind, every time things move and transition into new seasons, there's a check-in that needs to happen because there's something about what's going on in your inside, your intellect and everything that we don't know. Right. So I think what Mr. Donald was saying, I would want to know as a woman, okay, how do I communicate with you to know what season you're in? Because I don't know if your vision has changed. I don't know if you are wanting to add to something or take something away. There has to be an effective way. And I know my thought process with fellas is they internalize a lot. But one thing I want to say is if God has placed a woman or a someone that you confide in into your life, trust the process. Trust that that is what they're there for. Like he said, what you need, not what you want. If it's a need, if she's there meeting those needs, then you need to, in my opinion, you need to kind of soften up and allow her to get in there and help the process. Because without a vision, we kind of wander as well when a man doesn't have one to give.
Right.
If you cannot, if you cannot effectively communicate that vision, then the vision is it ends up nowhere with nothing.
Well, one of the things too, I agree on communication is very important. You know, if you have children in your life and your family and everything, it's a lot going on. And I'm gonna just share this with y'all. I was saying in church, I was saying everywhere, the best thing could ever happen to my family was the pandemic. People didn't understand, people don't misunderstood, but let me tell you something. Everything stopped. Me and my family hadn't played Monopoly in I don't know how many years. We was able to sit down to the table and eat together. We was able to sit down to the table and play Monopoly. We was able to have communication and get to know my daughters and things they do. My family, my wife going here, taking my daughter to dance, she taking this to the tutor, and they going to the AKA meetings. Everybody going different ways. Nobody staying still. They say, be still and know that I am God.
Right.
So now, I was able to sit down and we was able to talk. Not talk at each other, but talk to each other.
Yeah.
Huh? We was able to talk, have communication. And then we was able to walk together. Me and my wife started walking together. Then we got to say, okay, we got to compromise in the fact that this is what you like. Okay, I'm going to do this. But at the same time, what I like, I need you to do the same thing. We need to compromise with each other. What Brother Donald was saying is very important that we communicate. Communication is the key. You know, when I was in seminary school for a while, I talked to Dr. Rentz. He said the three things gonna mess up a marriage: sex, money, and communication. Those three things are going to mess up a marriage.
Yep.
If you don't communicate, if you don't talk about it, it's going to mess it up. My man already said, if we don't, we got the money, then what we supposed to do with it? You know, we supposed to save some. We supposed to give some out, help somebody else, somebody less than fortunate. We supposed to do some things with that money, not be selfish. I tell my daughter all the time, you cannot be selfish because it's not about you. It's about somebody else.
That's right.
You know, so we got to help somebody else. At the same time, we're going to help ourselves. So we got to communicate. It's the key to it.
Right.
You know, but sometimes we don't want to communicate. Sometimes we don't communicate.
Yeah.
You know, and it's important that we do. You know, but we got to keep it moving. I got to keep going because I'm determined that to have that $250,000 or more. You understand what I'm saying? So if he don't give it to me, I can't bless nobody else.
Communication very key, but I believe 2020 we all have to like step our game up, have organized communication between man and woman in the household. We all got different roles. We got personal things we trying to do. You know what I mean? We got the job situation. We got different things. We have to now get organized, write things down. I believe that we kind of have developed lazy habits. How can if you're in a relationship with someone you married 30, 40, 50 years, how can you remember all of the important conversations that you had, you know, when you've got bills, children, your health, family, job, personal development, spiritual growth, extracurricular activities, challenges, things like that. So I believe really culturally, hint, hint, you know what I'm saying? You know, we need to get organized with our communication and writing things down, not necessarily pen and paper. If you are a hell breather and you use your hands may hurt. But we got emails, we got text messages, we got ways to archive so we can have effective and organized communication.
So, what do you need or desire from a woman? That's my question. Like, what do you need? What do you feel? What really makes you want to get up every day? Especially being someone in a relationship, someone that's married. What made you want to marry her to begin with? What made you think that she was the one for you? So what do you feel or what do you need or desire from a woman?
Just add to that real quick, Dee. And then on piggyback on that part, also, what makes you not
want
to marry? What makes you not?
Yeah. What is your turn
on? So both of those.
Yeah. Oh, you want to.
So D was going.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Communication is supposed to start before the marriage. So I feel like, because everything is saying like communication. I feel, yeah, communication is key, but communication is supposed to start from the beginning. So when something in a relationship is happening, y'all supposed to be able to talk. If y'all not able to talk then, it was no communication to begin with.
Right.
So that's where we gotta find where is that, right? And then we gotta understand too, people come into relationships hurt sometimes. And they don't even deal with that hurt first before they come into a relationship.
Right.
And so they figure, oh, I'm coming into a relationship, he or she gonna help me out with this problem, right?
Right.
That person may be there to want to help you, but if you don't want me to help you, I can't help you.
That's
but
right.
You're still in this relationship,
right.
And I'm trying to help you.
That's right.
I'm giving my all to you because that's what I want.
That's right.
But if you're not giving me,
that's right.
Come on.
What we gonna do? But guess what? Because I'm a man, I'm a carrier. Because why? I want that relationship.
Oh, wow.
Because why? You keep showing me and telling me you want to be with me. And I know you're hurting. But I keep asking you, what's wrong? But if you're not saying nothing, okay, I'll ask you later. Come on. But I keep coming back to you. What's wrong? You don't want to say nothing? All right, come on. I'm going to carry it. I see you hurting, though. I see you hurting. I know you hurting. But if I'm asking you what's happening and you ain't saying nothing, what are we doing? But I'm the man. If I care about you, I ain't going nowhere. So I'm going
to
carry the load. Because that's what I'm supposed to do. You're supposed to balance me out.
Right.
You're supposed to counterbalance. Mm-hmm. You ain't supposed to carry the weight. I don't need you to carry the weight. I already got it. I need you to balance with me. So if I'm coming to you and saying, hey, it's a problem here, or it's a problem there, but you don't want to talk about it, what we going to do?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And women, we got to understand that too. Y'all,
that's true.
We come to y'all.
Yep.
And but with the society, it make the man feel weak, or when we gotta come to y'all. Because sometimes we'll come to y'all, y'all might never believe it. Because, oh, you a man, hey, man up. Alright. And we do it and we keep moving. But we want y'all to be like, y'all see me, right? Y'all see me hurting, y'all see me carrying it, right?
Yeah.
You gotta help me out. You gotta acknowledge it. And there's nothing wrong with you acknowledging it. Because I already see it. I just want you to ride with me.
So I agree with what you're saying. As women, we have to acknowledge that as well. So because as women, we can be condescending. So we need to be in a place to where we acknowledge it, where it's understood and it's accepted. So I agree with that. That's good.
So with what you just said, because you were making a statement that we can see you hurting.
Yeah.
Right.
And by us seeing you hurting, what is one of the things that would, for you as a man, allow you to be vulnerable with the woman that you choose?
If I know you are hurt by something, sometimes words, you can't say nothing to comfort you. I'll hug you though. I'll comfort you. I'm gonna be there for you.
Right?
But if I say, if you know I'm hurting, you ask me if I'm hurting, I'm gonna tell you. If you already know, like, just comfort me. You feel me? Because I'm going to do the same for you. Just listen. Because y'all say that to us. We do it. Y'all got to do it as well.
Right.
You feel me? And if you see a problem, say that problem. Say, oh, I got a problem with this. And why you got a problem with it? Like, talk to us. Because we're going to talk to y'all the same way. But men, we take stuff and we just ride with it because, you know what I'm saying? But that is a bad thing at times. But some of the stuff that we shrug off be so small, we don't even look at it as a big deal because that's how we move. But at the same time, if y'all see us or y'all see something, speak up. Speak up, you know? Yeah, go ahead.
When is the proper time?
Anytime.
When is the proper time?
Whenever you feel it, say it.
Okay.
Why let it linger?
You're right.
If you upset, say you upset.
Okay.
We all get upset. Say why you upset though, and then when we talk about it, leave it there.
Okay.
Leave that anger there, cause if we come back and talk about this, we shouldn't be mad about it no more, cause we already faced it.
Agreed.
It's okay to talk about it, but we can't be mad about the same thing. We
got
to keep moving. If we ain't improving, we losing.
Right.
Simple as that. But we gotta talk.
I know.
You feel me?
It's two different things. You could be talking to somebody or you could be talking at somebody.
Come on, that's
and the
true.
Problem with a lot of relationships, we snap on each other. And that's not love. Love is patient, kind, you know, all the fruits of the spirit. You know what I'm saying?
Come on,
when you have those things, you sit down and you realize you're not enemies, y'all partners.
Right.
So anything hurdle y'all can get over with, y'all gonna be successful. Because y'all jump that hurdle together. This like what we do when we get married. We jump that broom, don't we? That's what we got to do. People think, oh, we're going to handle all our problems before the marriage. That's not reality. You're going to go in marriage. You're going to have problems. You just got to work them out together and talk. Like you say, you got to talk to each other, not at each other. And that, to me, that's what's going to make y'all successful. Talking to each other, not at each other.
Okay, so are those the things that you need as a man in a relationship? So you need effective communication. So everything keeps going back to effective communication.
Right.
It really
love.
Is.
That's not effective.
Well,
just
in, yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Right. We got to understand, like, society plays a lot with it.
It's hard enough. It,
exactly. You know what I'm saying?
To be hard
that part.
Yeah.
That part.
Yeah.
That
right.
part.
And we'll say, I'll say.
Okay, this, so this, I'm,
no,
I want to, I want, okay, oh. boom.
All right, so piggybacking off of what Larry D. Woods was saying, it is vitally important when the wife or when your girl, whoever, is hurting. It doesn't necessarily take them going ahead and saying it. Sometimes you can actually see it through their eyes. Verbally, you can tell by their attitudes, their whole demeanor changes. Everything changes. So if something is going off on the key, a different perspective, like let's say for instance, one thing happens. You're in a happy mood, you know, your wife or whoever is in a happy mood, the person that you're with is in a happy mood. Next thing you know, something happens that completely shifts the atmosphere completely shifts the way how that woman is feeling. You on the inside are going to be feeling it. It doesn't necessarily need to, you don't necessarily need to see it, but when she walks in the door, it, say for instance my wife, she goes inside or she goes someplace else, she's having a blast and everything, it takes one thing. Takes one thing to shut the whole thing down. Oh crap, what happened? What happened? And then you want to go ahead and address it. Why? Because we as men want to try and fix it. That's our point. That's what God blessed us with. But if we're not sensitive.
Come on.
If we're not sensitive to those things, and yet the Holy Spirit had to jack me up on it several times on it too. Now is not the time to go ahead and talk about it. Dad, I want to talk about it now. I want to get this over with, man, because this is burning me up. She's going to bed with this weight on her shoulder. Didn't I say to cast this care on me? Okay, I'll let it go. But at the end of the day, God, I want to know what's going on. I want to know what's happening. How can I make it work? Just trust me, I got this. Some things, as men, we got to be comfortable with. God got it. That's your daughter? I'm going to let you handle that. And that's hard for us because we want to help. We want to fix it. We want to make it right. That's bottom line. End of the story. But at the end of it all, if he has it, we ain't got nothing to do with it. Let him handle it. That's my perspective on that.
A lot of times we have to learn to back up, you know, and sit back and let God handle some things. It's not easy.
Yeah.
It's not easy at all. Facts. Now, the other thing my brother was saying here is that we got to let that past go, and now we're working on the future. We're focused on what's going on now, not what's back then, because we can't do what's happened back then. I used to tell my mama, "Mom, you live too much in the past. My uncle, you live too much in the past. What's going on right now?" A lot of people are Americanized. You know, it was different. We're supposed to be kings and queens. We're supposed to be different things in life. Yeah. But now, we just got to focus on, like we're saying, communication, talk about it. And sometimes, you know, baby, we ain't going to talk about it right now. Right. You know, the time ain't right. Like he's saying, the time ain't right. You know, because, you know, you get upset. You know, my man was talking about he might snap at each other. The time ain't right. I done been in a situation where I had to walk away and then I had to come back and the next day say, "Baby, what's wrong? What's wrong?" You know, and explain, you know, I'm upset, I'm not comfortable because they saying, well, I'm carrying the load. And then, you know, the man figured himself out. And I just had to tell myself that I got to do what I feel I know that I need to do for me and then let her see what I'm talking about that happened. I had to actually step away from what I was doing, what I know I'm supposed to be doing, stuff like this right here, a motivational speaker, and my wife saying, "I need you to do this. Go get this job, go do this." That's what God told me to do. So I had to make that decision. But I needed from her to support me in what I was doing. Now, she's saying that my wife is going to get her doctorate degree, and she's saying, "Baby, you got to take care of the business." And God has blessed.
When we, you know, the question is about what does a man need or desire from a woman?
Yes.
I think that first and foremost, it'll go back to the first question about vision. The man has to know what his vision is, what his purpose is, and different things like that. God has given all of us talents and abilities and different strengths. But also with that, with us just being humans, we have weaknesses.
Yeah.
So I think that if we're talking about getting into a relationship or going into a relationship, if I know that as a man, this is all my solid points, I'm good like this, I can handle this, this how I move, whatever, what I would need and desire from my woman is I would need her to be strong in my weak areas.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So then we complement each other. You know what I'm saying? So now that we're able to flow, and it would also be vice versa. We was having a conversation in the barbershop one time, And a lot of dudes come in and they complain about their women. Man, she like this and she this and she that. Da 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 da. And I remember my dad said it. He say, you know, when are men gonna realize sometimes, hey man, maybe I just chose the wrong women. Mm. Yeah. Maybe she just don't fit what I got going on. And yeah. there's nothing wrong with that. Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that. We cannot. What end up happening? And as I sit back and I listen, what end up happening is that we put a lot of stuff on God that we shouldn't put on God. Yeah, right. You know what I'm saying? God is a God of law. He's a God of principle. Same. So if you know that He's created you this way and He's made you this way, you gotta be able to accept who you are, and then be able to find the right spouse or the right mate or whoever to complement what you got going on, and vice versa. So then we eliminate a lot of those problems. We eliminate a lot of the heartache, a lot of the stress and stuff like that. Instead of we trying to go to God and pray that He changed this woman from being this, that, that, and the third. Yeah. So now then when He changed her, now she ain't happy no more.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's what when it comes down to what a man needs or what he may desire, and from my perspective, that man needs he needs his woman to be able to compliment him in his weak points. You know what I'm saying? He needs to be able to compliment her in her weak areas, because then that's going that and that too, because we're built to want to solve problems and different things like that. When I know that I compliment her in her weak areas, that's going to boost me up and make me feel good too. You know what I'm saying? So that's me, man.
You know, for us as women, you all need to be able to admit that I have this weakness, but also know that she has your best interest at heart as well. She's not gonna hurt you in that, and know that it might take her time. It might take her time to understand, okay, here's something new I'm dealing with. I've never dealt with this type of man before.
Right.
I don't know how to deal with this type of man. So give me some time. Like I tell my husband, I say, I see this is going on, but I need a little time to understand. I need a little time to take it in so I can know how to help you.
Yes.
But always think that everything that I do is out of positive intent.
Well, no.
It's out of love for you. It is not to hurt you, because you're mine. You're my baby. So that's one thing that you all have to understand from us. But again, you know, give us time with that weak point.
So one thing as well is also the need. I feel like need is way more than desire.
Right.
So back to your point of God gives you what you need, not always what you want or desire.
Mm-hmm.
So with that point, need.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to know your weakness.
Yes.
We need to know. And if that woman does not fit you in the space of you being able to be vulnerable, then you don't need her.
Right.
Because if you don't feel like she is a person that you can be most vulnerable with, because, you know, we got these people think like this. Okay, well, if I tell you this, you might throw it in my face later.
Right. Correct.
Okay, but guess what?
That's real.
We throw that around the house all day. Mm-hmm. You should know that at a certain point, something very vulnerable will not go outside of these four walls. Mm-hmm. Everybody has their disagreements in a relationship. Even in a business relationship, you have disagreements. So relationships in general, you have different disagreements. But my point is, if you don't feel like that woman is, if you could put that risk on her, if you know, Charlie Wilson say, put the money on me. If you can't put the money on me, then you shouldn't be with me.
Right.
Because then that forfeits me for being the best woman that I can be for you.
And to piggyback off of that, if you can't be transparent, if you can't be vulnerable with that person, then you definitely don't need to be in a relationship.
That's right. That's right.
Because if I'm in a relationship with you, it's long term. I don't think of being in a relationship with someone as being a short term thing.
Well, first of all, we're too old.
Why are we too old for that? So first, you need to identify what you want. And you have to tell the woman what you want. If you don't want to be in a relationship with her, you just want to have a little buddy, y'all know what I'm talking about, then she needs to know. Like, hey, homegirl, you just a buddy. And then let her decide if that's what she wants to do. If, you know, hey, if she want to decide to still be that, then let her be that.
So I think that the need is, in this segment, I think the need is so much far greater than the desire. But we desire for things. I mean, I know you desire, you know, you desire to have something that, you know, look right on your arm. But that's far less important than what you need to build yourself as a man and get to that next level and be the father, be the, you know, the inspiration, the motivation. Because we do, as women, desire a solid man. And we're not saying
Most definitely.
Like you Hercules. We're saying solid in knowing who you are.
Yes.
Your weakness, you admitting your weakness is solid to me as a woman. Because I know that you're that much more vulnerable to be able to work on that area, you know, or you're admitting I need to work on that area. You know, we can't be the only ones like, babe, look, I'm weak in this area. I'm looking at, I'm weak in this area. No, because then you just sitting around and we just being vulnerable, telling you everything, and then we don't have anything to run off of. So now we feel like it's a one-sided relationship.
Right.
And that's where the carrying the load that you were speaking on, that's where it starts for us as women, because it's like, okay, I'm telling this man everything, I'm being vulnerable, I'm being transparent, but he's sitting around like, and I don't have anything to go off of. Right. So it's like the women, the woman starts to feel like they're weighing and being weighed on and being burdened with everything, because it's like, I don't know where your thought process is.
What do you need? What do you desire from your mate? I feel that question is when there's a problem. I mean, I lost my desire for you. If we're together, my desire has already been met.
That's right.
Because we still rocking. You feel me? So if I lost desire for you, something happened. And so if my desire didn't lose for you, but you're acting different to me,
then her desire might have changed.
So you need to tell me your desires now. Because my desires are the same, because I'm still here with you, treating you the same way, talking to you the same exact way, giving you all of me the same exact way from jump. So if you lost a desire, it's not a problem with me. Because my desire is to be with you. Because I'm still here trying to work on it. So if you're not telling me what's happening, you can't. I'm still here. So if you're not saying nothing, what? Y'all got to talk. So we saying my desire is to be with you. And I'm showing you is to be with you. And then y'all lose desire. Why you lost desiring? What is it that changed? So you need to tell me.
One thing I will say, and one thing that I thought was very becoming of him, is you got to check the mirror and make sure that you are still who you portrayed yourself to be
from the beginning.
You know, because desires to me are lost when the expectation that we put on you, whether you allowed us to put that on you or we put it on ourselves, is something's altered. And it's like, okay, if I want a man that is goal oriented, if he's doing everything that he says he's doing from the beginning, and something is dwindling, and I am asking what's going on, but he's not vulnerable enough to tell me that he's lost himself, then I'm kind of moving along, and the lack of communication, it starts to feel like, okay, well, He doesn't feel like he can confide in me to tell me what's going on. So then I start to feel as a woman like, well, maybe I'm not in this season what he wants to be, you know, possibly with.
So something happened that you lost trust because I'm still doing me.
Right.
I'm still in my vision.
Right.
So if you think something is wrong, you need to speak up. Because guess what? I'm still moving in my vision. You still in my vision too. I'm still giving you what you need from me as a man, as well as I'm doing what I need to do as a man. So if you feel that your desire or whatever the case may be is altered or shifted, talk to me. Cause why? Yeah, cause we in the car together. If you hear a rattle in the car, hey, what's that, babe?
Right.
Oh, I'ma tell you. We gotta get our axle fixed.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about? You gotta speak.
Trust and commitment is important to me because if we have a vision, established vision, and I trust her and committed to that, and she trusts me and we're committed to that, then that's going to alleviate a whole bunch of those insecurities. And I think that our inability to talk and communicate comes from insecurities. But if I know that I have a woman that is committed to this vision that we've already established, and she trusts me, I trust her, we're committed to that, I think a whole bunch of these problems that we just talked about would just go away. So to me, vision is very important first, and being able to effectively communicate that vision, and then having that woman that you can trust and is committed to that. And I think that after that, it's success.
We go out and try to find our soulmate when God, he's going to send that to you. That was my mistake in the past. A lot of relationships, I thought I found a girl. You know, it was never the right one because I went looking for it. You don't go and find your soulmate. God sends that to you. So that's why I think a lot of mistake in when it comes to what do you need from, you know, your significant other. Your soulmate is going to tap in and y'all pray together and y'all going to meet each other's needs because y'all are soulmates. And y'all, like, you know, y'all fit each other like a glove. And I think that's why a lot of people, you know, they get in relationships with these high expectations and stuff when they're with the wrong person because they went and looked for that person instead of allowing God to send you that person.
I want to talk about something as far as needs in a relationship. Something I think this is kind of a new concept is awareness of what the male experience is outside of the house. And I'm going to talk about this a lot. I've heard certain terms, like communication is very key. And sometimes it's not what you're communicating, it's how you communicate it. So I want to talk about this. Outside of the house as a male experience, when we on the job, a lot of times we have people talk to us who don't respect us.
Yeah.
And we have to deal with that.
Yeah.
A lot of times as men and leaders, we are leaders in real life. But on the job, we got someone less qualified leading us, talking to us, treating us any kind of way. If women could have a heightened level of awareness about the male experience as far as, when I'm outside this house, I'm not respected, I'm not valued, you know what I'm saying? I'm not catered to. People don't care about my feelings outside of this house. If they had an awareness of what that experience was outside the house, I believe it would be better inside the house. It'd be more patience, more understanding. It'd be also more. I'm gonna talk about this too. The influence of a woman is so underrated. If women could really have an awareness of their influence, and I'm gonna give a real elaborate analogy, okay? Men are like houses. We can provide shelter, okay? And we can protect you from the elements.
Okay.
A woman is almost like a realtor team. She's either gonna add value to the house, build the house up, or she gonna help this house dilapidate. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so I believe if women had if they can improve, not saying they're not aware, but if they were really aware of the male experience outside the house, this is what, and the male experience before I met you. You know, you may appreciate me, you may value me, but before you came around, I may not have been valued in society. I may not have been valued by women that look like you. I may not have been valued by the woman that I'm supposed to love first, my mother. You know, deep-rooted issues. Okay, and then also the awareness of their influence. They're either going to add value to a man, build him up, or they're going to help them lead him to self-destruction and help the man get tore down. Boom.
That goes back to what you guys were saying about us men needing to be vulnerable. I feel that in the society that we live, our culture, men, has always been raised to be tough, hard, nothing can affect us, and if something does affect us, we've been taught to internalize it, never to materialize and say, hey, this is what's going on with me. Now with the shift of society and how things are changing, it's being more acceptable for us black men to say, hey, listen, this is how I feel. Because in years past, it was always to be looked upon as if you say something, that means you soft.
Right.
You can't hold your own. Okay, so with that being said, for a man needing something and desire, vulnerability is that. Because when a man feels that he can be vulnerable with a woman, that allows her to understand what the male experience for us is out there. While we are with you, when we're not with you, before you also. Because like he said, we go through a lot of things in life out there dealing with lesser people than us.
Right.
All day, every day.
Right.
And we know good and well we should be above these people. But due to the way that society may dictate or may not dictate certain things, it is what it is.
Right.
So the fact that being able to be vulnerable to a woman for her to understand what our experience is out there, that's what the communication in turn comes back to in the middle. Because when 50 and 50 is being brought into the middle, that's when 100% effort is being maximized.
But is it fair to say that 100% needs to be brought on both angles? I think society has told us it's 50-50 thing and we've been rolling with it. But 100, because you have to be 100. Then she has to be 100.
That's 2,000.
I think is going to be important as well is what you need. You need a woman as well as a woman needs a man that knows their love language.
Yes.
You need to know how you want to be loved. What is your A1, day one, that's going to make it work? If you don't know that, then you need to date yourself a little longer and know how you want to be loved. Because people don't know how they want to be loved. And it's hard for other people to love you if you don't even know how you want to be loved.
This is very a key component. In 2020, with the uncertainty, with everything going on in the world, what men really need from women, we need your loyalty. We need your most intimate commitment. That's what I came up with. Gentlemen talked about being pampered, you know, and we want that affection and things like that. But that affection don't mean nothing if you sharing that affection with somebody else. It's not exclusive.
That go vice versa too.
Vice versa. It is vice versa. But it's like this though. It same stand. You're right. Same standard. This is for all men and women.
Yes.
Same standard across the board. We need loyalty. Your most intimate commitment. If you're sharing yourself with someone, you should only be sharing yourself with that person. Straight up. That's just how I feel. Because it don't mean anything. It don't mean anything.
Right.
You know, like that pampering and that intimacy, that female energy that we get that is undeniable and irreplaceable, it doesn't mean anything if it's not, if there's no loyalty, if it's not exclusive. Loyalty over everything. Love is cool, but loyalty only for you. That's what I'm...
That person really mean what they doing. Yes, loyal to me. Absolutely. I just want to get some understanding. I know what you said about getting understanding.
Authenticity.
So we're saying when you saying loyalty, you're saying that person is doing it not just because it's they your wife. They're doing it because they want to do it.
I'm saying when I'm saying loyalty, and I mean specifically like commitment, like no infidelity. You know what I mean? Like you're only offering yourself to this one person. A lot of people have the upgrade mindset. Okay, I'm gonna rock with you right now until I get something else that's a little better. When something else a little better come around, okay, boom, loyalty go out the window. You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna go with that. You know what I'm saying? And I believe that's not a real connection. That doesn't help build families. That doesn't help build positive marriages. It don't help good business ethics. Loyalty is that X factor I believe in too. In this world, it's a lot of uncertainty that we live in. We can't depend on the government to do things correctly. We can't depend on the authority figures to do things correctly. We can't depend on what they tell us what's going on in the world. But we need loyalty from our mate that we with. This is our life partner that we are, that we're joining worlds with.
That's right.
You feel me? Going forward, we need real loyalty. Not just I'm here right now because it's cool. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You feel me?
And I understand because I want to say this. I want to say this too. What we're talking about now is I went to a marriage counselor and I want to share this with y'all. I tried my best to buck the marriage counselor. I tried my best not to go. I promise you. I said it was February the 28th. It was the first of the month. I'm the fruit man. I got bills to pay. I got things to do. And you want me to go to marriage counseling. So I went to marriage counseling with my wife at her church. First love. I got the marriage counseling. Pastor Jomo and his wife kept it real. 1,000. Straight up. I was listening. I'm learning. I'm paying attention. Then they had a woman of God come. At the time, we didn't make plans for my wife to stay. She had to go and pick up my daughter, but the woman of God spoke. I said, as soon as they got finished, I told my wife, she got back, we went and prayed. I said, I'll go to marriage counseling with that woman because she is speaking the truth. Amen. I learned something from the marriage counseling. I took something in. I applied it to my life, and I learned something. I was happy that I went. I just believed that I got more out of it than she did. But I did learn something. And I want to just say to men, we have to be open to some things sometimes and willing to learn and listen and learn and apply it to ourselves. And one thing they said, what he was just talking about, he's talking about, they were saying, this is a person you talking about, you were saying committed to, you going to spend the rest of your life. I said, Lord have mercy. Huh? Because it don't always going, you know, it always don't go. It ain't always going my way. It ain't always going her way. So you talking about a, they hit me like a ton of bricks. When they said that to me, that you're saying, I'm going to spend this my rest of my life with this person. And so we got to communicate. We got to talk. We got to go through some things in life. And I have to go through some things. She got to go through some things. And then we got to still come together. It's real. You know, this is real. This is what the man talking about. Commitment. And then, you know, the outside ain't going to help you, but the inside. You know, so I'm saying, I just had to really pay attention and start looking in the mirror at myself. You know, looking at what I can do. What he's saying, you know, what my man over there talking about, it go both ways. It just don't go one way. We got to come back. And he said about the part about when somebody's hurting or somebody's going through. We need to, I'm vulnerable. I don't have a problem with telling you about my weakness. I ain't get the syllables and all that stuff. That ain't me. I ain't get some things I tell them I ain't get. They picked at me in my own house, my daughter, my wife. I ain't get those things. But what I do got is I got the Lord, and he's my Savior. Amen. And he supplied my every need. Amen. He will come and see about me. Now, I know the seed, know my name, and nobody can do nothing about it. They can't take it from me. They can't take it away because God has gave me a gift that nobody else has. I believe it. I know for a fact because I had to apply myself.
I just want to say something in closing. I came here. He asked me to come, and I didn't know it was going to be this great. And I really appreciate it. Some child brothers here. I mean, I've young brothers, older brothers, sisters. It's just really, I really got something out of this, you know, and I really got different views of different things. But my main thing to my success of my marriage to the same woman for 35 years is you stay till the love come back.
Yeah.
Because it's going to come and go. You're going to have differences. You're going to have all that kind of thing. But the key thing is staying till the love come back. Sometimes that means removing yourself from the home, which I've done before. When I say move from the home, I mean I went and rented me an apartment for a week or so, a month or so, to give somebody some break. Sometimes you need a break. It don't mean you go and have somebody else or something. It's just give you time, because it really gives you time too. Right now I have a business where I'm out in Lutz, and I'm out there from Tuesdays to Saturdays. On Saturdays evening, I can't wait to get home to come to my wife. I hate to leave her tonight, but she know that's what we have to do to get where we need to get to.
Right.
So you have all that falls in line, and you start understanding one another. You start going through things with one another. You communicate with one another. You sit down and you talk, regardless of whatever you have to do. But the key to it all is just staying till the love comes back. Simple as that.
I understand that, just marriage in general, right? Like, I just get it. Like, old school, high school, it don't matter to me. I feel the basis of marriage is marriage. You feel me? If you break the vows, right, you gotta come back to the person and to God and tell them, hey, I messed up these vows. Because if you don't do that and you decide to keep going with this marriage, it's never going to be on the same page. You ain't going to love me the same way. Because I'm still moving, or whoever's still moving, in love in this marriage. They didn't break the vow. You feel me?
Right.
If you believe in God, you believe in vows, you live and walk with it when you marry. So if somebody do something against those vows, don't get back in line before they jump back into marriage, it's going to be different.
Yes.
I ain't gotta stay there if you don't love me. Why?
Right.
If I'm begging you, what's happening? Or you change it, and I'm saying, why do you still want to be here? If I'm asking you, do you still want to be married? What am I doing? That means I'm fighting for this, right? But if you're not fighting with me, I'm not fighting no more. Right. Cause then that's what I'm gonna start doing. Sooner or later, I'm gonna be swinging on myself. And then no, then I'm looking in the mirror like, dang, I just bruised myself. For what? No, I love you, right? But I ain't gotta stay with you. Yeah. No, God didn't say that.
Mm-mm. Thank you so much to Mr. Donald Mitchell here at Sheer Excellence for allowing us to come here. The location is 4707 East Bush Boulevard. Ladies, come get your hair cut. Fellas, come in. Bring your boys, bring your team, whoever you want. But this is the type of conversation we have here at Sheer Excellence. Shop Talk. See you soon.